the kind of fear that makes your body freeze.
I'm not playing with her again.
This guy wants to hit me. I need to hit this guy. You know, he's trying to kill me. You could die in a ring.
You hit towards my sanity! I would have rather you swung your cock around with a frowsy landlady.
What are you gonna do?
I will never be able to paint again.
You listen to me, and you listen good. You are more than the things you achieve. You hear me?
Eleanor, and I just had my film shown at the BFI after working on it since September. It's a film based on the thoughts that go through women's heads on a daily basis that other people may not think about or have had the opportunity to think about.
And we wanted to recreate a 18th century dressing room, which is a very niche thing and something to actually find hard to find evidence of and also light it. Obviously in 18th century it was lit mostly by candlelight, which was a challenge in itself. But my cinematographer has done a great job of understanding that and playing around with candles and our camera equipment and our opportunities to create great visual moments.
It's based in a forest. I went for a very stylized look just because I think it fit the theme of it being a very heartfelt, comedic, little sweet animation.
I did a film called I Close My Eyes to See, which is sort of a semi-autobiographical story about a girl who gets diagnosed with this health condition that could lead to blindness, which then leads her on this path of sort of self-destruction. And she's a painter, so as you can imagine, for somebody whose whole life is art, to be told they might not have eyesight, it's pretty painful. So that's sort of what the film is about, is dealing with this idea of the struggle of unforeseen diagnosis, to talk about my own stuff, but also to try and showcase how difficult this sort of thing was going to be.
I always say to everyone else as well, like my final year, I feel like it's the first time where I actually feel like an artist. I feel like in the other years, or like as a child, I was never an artist, I was just drawing and practicing. And now I have like a story to tell and I'm like ready to share it with people.
I've spent 4 years of my life in this university, coming back and forth, getting ready to learn something every year, getting ready to make another project, getting ready to be surrounded by my peers and my lecturers, just being in that environment where I can learn and thrive. And now it's gonna be gone, and that's really scary, really upsetting, but at the same time, it's an achievement.
Coming towards the end of the degree, like we've all been through so much during COVID, like I think that's why the work this year has been so good, because we all have like these amazing stories to tell. We're all going through this like shared historical event that is COVID and not being able to see your family and friends. I think that's why the stories are so great, and like I've realized like these are the people that I want to work with in the future.
It was crazy. It looked so much better on the screen than it did on my laptop at home. Just the sounds and the vast like screen of it, it just looked amazing.
We all know each other, we all root for each other's film, we all came to the BFI not to see our own film, but to see everyone else's film. Like, I know for a fact that everyone here was like, okay, I'm gonna go to the BFI because I can't wait to see this person and that person's film. Like, I have been watching them work on it for like a year now. I have seen them grow as a person, as an artist, for 4 years, and I can't wait to see what they've achieved.
Everyone is a winner. Everyone is a winner, seriously.
I'm gonna miss it.
4 years of my life have gone into this degree, and I'm very happy that I was a part of it.